troubleshooting a Frigidaire front load washing machine, and the complaint is no motor movement at all. The machine will still pump out. This unit has a separate drain pump in front, but the wash motor in back there does not energize at all. It's not getting voltage, won't tumble, won't spin. So what I'm going to do, get that to focus here, and this is the ladder diagram for the motor. And I don't know if it's come through on the camera, but if no motor rotation during fill or agitation, and that matches our complaint. So I'm going to be doing a live voltage check and see if I'm getting voltage clear on out through the pressure switch. This will check these particular timer contacts. This will check the door switch contacts here. It'll also check my pressure switch. And if I'm getting voltage, if the pressure switch is properly actuating on pin 3, which I've got written in here as the aqua pin, and I got that off the wiring diagram. This is a tech sheet, by the way, and it lives in here. If you're a tech and watching this, please don't steal it. Put it back where you got it for the next guy or for you when you come back. So I'm looking for 120 volts to be switched out of this pressure switch on pin 3, and that's what I'm going to check for now. Okay, I've started up the machine in fill, and you'll notice that there's no drum movement at all. On this machine, there should be a little tumble back and forth to help wet the clothes thoroughly as the water is being put in. Pressure switch, this is a stack unit, so I've got it pulled out a little bit and the dryer tipped back. And the pressure switch is located right here up top. Pin 3, let's see if that comes through. There's my aqua wire. I have it disconnected just because I want to read the voltage at pin 3. I'm going to explain that why in a minute. Normally you would want to check voltage with it connected, but I'm going to explain why I'm doing this in just a second. Okay, so I'm coming in here. I'm on pin 3 there. I've got my 120. That pressure switch, the fact that I'm getting it out of pin 3 where that aqua wire connects, means that switch is switching correctly. Now, here's why I took it off, because I was getting I was getting 120. Here I am just on that dangling aqua wire that goes on pin 3 of the pressure switch. I was getting 120 there regardless of where I was. I should not be getting 120 volts on that aqua switch. That means it's backfeeding through the speed control board. So that's what we've got going on this unit, is the, and it's back there behind the boot. It's changed from the back. It's the motor control board, speed control board, inverter board, goes by various names. It controls the speed and direction of the wash motor. So we already showed that the speed control board is definitely bad, also called the motor control board. And what I'm going to do now, just to check the motor and make sure we're not also dealing with a bad motor, you'll notice here on the wiring diagram, you can come down here. These are the windings in the motor. And you can actually take your meter and you can ohm out. You disconnect that harness that connects to the speed control board so you're not reading back through that. And you can ohm out these windings here on tan white, orange black, and then orange black to red black. And I'll show you where that is. There's the motor harness connector right here. The colors they're referring to are back here. So you have to disconnect this harness. This is from the speed control board. And you match up the colors on the back side of the harness. So, like, there's my tan white, there's my orange black, there's my red black. Those are my three. These correspond here. Sorry about that. It was off a little bit. Those are my three. Those correspond to my three windings in my motor. And that, because I know how the orientation of that harness connector corresponds to these three wires here. Black, blue, red. I can take my meter and ohm between these two, and they should get very low ohms. Yes. If anything's open, and I can also ohm between them and ground. And that's how you check the motor. You should get low voltage, or low ohmage between the windings, and it should be infinite open ohms between any of the windings and ground. Okay, so you see I've got my probes in there, in the top two. There I'm actually measuring, let me get that to focus here.
Oh, honey, I'm so glad.
I'm actually measuring the continuity here. Now what you're really interested in is the...
I'm sorry, I can't hear you. here. Excuse me just a minute.
The resistance needs to be the same in all those windings. So, as you heard, my customer had a phone call while I was trying to explain about measuring the resistance of the motor windings. Just wanted to wrap that up and make sure that that point came through clearly, that what you're looking for is that the windings should all have something low ohms. We're seeing like 2.3 ohms. You want to make sure also that all of the windings are very close to each other, like within half an ohm of each other. That's key in these types of three-phase motors. The last thing you want to make sure of is that there is no path from the motor windings to ground. So you'll check from the windings to the casing of the motor. You want to make sure there's nothing going there. And if all of that checks out, then as far as you're able to tell with the meter, the motor is good. That just leaves a speed control board, and that's what was replaced in this washer. Problem solved.